jazz blues progression. Turnaround progression that will set your blues on fire. Coming up. Jazz. After this video, you'll be familiar with jazz. You'll get a good idea of how jazz works out and everything, and that's what we're going to get into today. But we're going to go over this, my most favorite jazz chord progression out there. It's, and we add it to the 12-bar blues that's in the turnaround. The last 11 and 12 bars, we add this chord progression in there, and it really brings it back to the top. It really turns it around, and that's what it's supposed to do. That's the turnaround, and that's how we get there. So it's typically in the basic 12-bar blues, that 11 and 12 bar is basically just you're in the one chord, and you can kind of just use the chord, the notes of that chord, and work it, bring everybody back to the top with your line. But you don't have to do that here. This is the chord progression will carry you in there. Just the tonal, the notes of it, just kind of push it around to each note and just brings it back around. It kind of, it's jazz for you. That's how jazz works. It's not, you know, jazz doesn't focus on the key as much as they focus on the chord. So the notes in that chord can be out of key. The key that you're in, like if you're in the, like we'll go over the one today, will be in the key of C. But the very first one chord of that blues progression is a dominant chord. So it's a C7. So it's actually like being in the key of F, but it's not, you're still in the key of C, but you're in that chord for that moment is a C7, and that's what makes the blues the blues. And now we're adding the jazz to the blues, and that's what's going to make it, that's what makes it the jazz blues, and makes it moves around a little more, and it's just a little more harmonious, as if I can say that. So that's basically what jazz is. Like I said, it focuses on the chord of the of that moment. And in this chord progression, each chord, the notes in those chords have resolutions and dissonance that want to push you to certain areas, either a half step below or a half step above. It will push you into that. The more of those pushing notes in that chord will move you melodically or modal around that to each note to bring you back to home. Okay, if that's not too confusing, like I say, it's deep, and it's just, I'm just a tip of the iceberg. So if you want to see more, check out iwantoplaybass.com, become a member, and we go over, we dig in deep into the blues and jazz, because they're, jazz being so intricate, and the blues, there's so much to do, and there's so much, even in jazz, there's so, it's unlimited what you can do. So, you know, we spend a lot of time on the jazz, on the blues and jazz, because there's so much to know, and there's so many opportunities in those two genres that's just never ending. And it's interesting, and it keeps it, you know, this easy stuff that you hear all the time, once you dig into it, it gets kind of deep. That easy stuff's not so easy, and it's, you know, it makes you a more well-rounded bassist by far. By knowing this, you don't have to add it to everything you play, but you'll find out you might end up enjoying a lot of jazz music once you know how it works and why it's working so well. You can appreciate that more by knowing what's going on. And so, you know, it's not like, wow, that's just too far out, I don't like it. You know, you can appreciate it once you figure out what they're doing and how it works. So check it out, jump on over there, iwantoplaybass.com, and get started on that. And we'll dig into this lesson here in a minute, get nitty gritty right here. Also, subscribe down below. I've got lots more videos, and I've got more videos that, like I say, this is just a tip of the iceberg, but I've got a lot more videos that kind of help work around that tip of that iceberg. And there might be something that you didn't catch here, or I didn't even talk about here, but it's in another video in the past, or I've got them coming up. So, like I said, this particular chord progression, the 12-bar blues chord progression, I broke down in depth in a video previously to this one, one of the videos. So check that one out, and you can get a better idea of how it works. But I'm not going to dig too deep into the voicings and everything. I'm just going to get right into that, my favorite chord progression, turnaround. So we're just going to start on C. C7 for one bar. That voicing right there. This is always that voicing right there. The last three notes, the strings, E8 or A, D, G, and C, E, B flat. That's the third and the seventh of the C7. C7 right here. That voicing, C7. Anywhere you go, that will always be a dominant seventh. That voicing, that pattern. This voicing will always be a minor seventh chord. Root, third, minor seventh. And dominant seventh, root, major third, minor seventh. Okay? So that voicing will always be a minor seventh chord anywhere you go. Anywhere you go, that pattern will be a dominant chord or minor chord. And we've got another one, but you're not sharing three strings. You're still sharing three strings, but you're not on those consecutive three strings. You're skipping a string. You're skipping an A string here. So that pattern there will always be skip a string, skip your A string, E, D, and G. That will always be a dominant pattern. This will always be a minor pattern. This will always be a major pattern. Okay, so back to the point. C7, one bar. F7, one bar. Back to C7 for two bars. Now that's our first four bars of the 12-bar blues. Now, the next four bars, we go to F7. Just visualize this in your head. Visualize four bars in the chord charts, the chord up chart. Visualize the chord chart. It's 12 bars, three lines, okay? So your first four bars, visualize the 1-7, the 4-7, the 1-7, and the 1-7. Just visualize that. Then the second line, visualize the 1-7, the 4-7, the diminished 7, and the 4, the 1-7, and the 6-7, okay? So we haven't gotten in that second bar, but just visualize that. So first four bars, 1-7, 4-7, 1-7, 1-7, two bars of 1-7, okay? Fifth bar, second line, 4-7, sharp diminished 7, just diminished 7. It's not necessarily going to be a sharp F sharp. This one is. Sliding up half step. So diminished 7. So 4-7, diminished 7, 1-7, 6-7. Okay? So that's 6-7. This is really the 6, but it's a dominant. Since we're in the blues, they're going to call out 4. That would be a dominant 7. It can be a minor 7 used as well, but in the blues, it's more typical going to be a dominant 7 there. So visualize the 4-7, diminished 7, 1-7, and 6-7. Okay, that's our second line. Third line, picture a 2 minor 7, a 5-7, and a 1-7. Okay, so, well, let me take that back. We won't. Just where this 1-7 is, visualize. Okay, so you've got the first two bars. There's a 2-7, 5-7. Second two bars, we're going to visualize four chords. There's going to be each bar is going to be split in half. So the 11th bar is going to be 1-7, 6-7, 12th bar is going to be 2-7, and 5-7, okay? So that's the turnaround that I get so excited about, is that 1-6-2-5. 1-6-2-5. And it breaks it down. It's half a bar each. It's two beats each. That's what's in the turnaround. That's what really drags you back to the top, without a doubt. So, like I said, picture the last four bars of that 12 bar, a 2-7, D minor 7. Today, we're talking about a D minor 7, 5-7, G7, 1-7, 6-7, 2 minor 7, C, G, 5-7, okay? So just picture those so you can incorporate that in any key that you want to be in. I don't want you to just get stuck to seeing the C key, being in the key of C. I don't want you to just picture, I want you to see the 1-7, 6-7, minor 7, and the 5-7, okay? But for this example, we're in the key of C, so we're going to be C7, A7, D minor 7, G7, back to, and then we're at the top right there, okay? So it's going to sound like this. Good. Get a little, like I say, start, we'll use a tempo, but just practice it slow. I mean, if I'm going to do 110, that's pretty slow, but if 110 seems still too hard to kind of grab the, you know, to give you enough time to figure out what's coming up next, then slow it down to 100, okay, or 90 or 60, you know, 60 is slow, you might fall asleep, but, you know, slow it down, nail it first, and then, you know, everything else will come afterwards. So this is 110, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll go through it one time, speed up, just so you can get a better feel for it. Like I say, this lesson will give you the ear training also that will get you familiar with that sound. Like I say, you probably heard it a million times, just never knew what it was, but that's what it is now. Now you know, and good things come to those who wait. 1, 2. Like I said before, subscribe, hit the bell notification. There's more coming out. Check out the previous ones that we've done just to get an idea of what what we're working with and breaking them down a little bit better. And check out iwantoplaybass.com. All right, great. Thank you all. See you.